Hey, how are you gonna lazy load your micro frontends without Angular routes? We'll see that in this video. Hi everyone, this is Subrat and you are watching Fun of Heuristic. So on this video today, we'll see how you're gonna lazy load your micro frontend without Angular routes. So if you remember in our previous video, and by the way, if you haven't watched the previous video, this video might look little irrelevant to you if you don't know what is dynamic model federation and how you can lazy load a micro frontend to your base app. So please go ahead and watch that video first. I will link that in the card and come here again. But if you know what is micro frontend and how you can implement it, please continue. So to lazy load the micro frontend without Angular router is quite easy. So instead of Angular route, we'll use a normal dynamic import. So for that, here I have the previous project which we have used in our previous video, and we'll just do this. So we'll create a view child. That form component we can use to render our micro frontend. So for that, we'll just create a method which we're going to call from our HTML, and in that method we'll import our lazy loaded module. If you remember from our previous video, or if you go to the route, we are doing the same. In our lazy load module, we are pointing to the load login slash component, which is our micro frontend module, and here micro frontend component, and we'll use that remote entry component, and we'll try to create a component from that remote entry component. And that's all from the TypeScript point of view. Now if we'll go to the HTML, here first we'll add an ng template with form component, so that now our view child or view container reference can access that and can embed a component in it. Okay, and if we'll just try to add a button here, which will call our load component, and load component will load the component. So what we're going to see here is that the login component, which is a micro frontend, will be loaded there. So I'll just save, and once the application is built, we'll go to the application here. When I will hit our load component button, it will load the micro frontend. And if you see that, it just downloaded the file. So I will just wrap things up. So if you want to load your micro frontend as a separate component in your application, then it's pretty simple. So you just need to import it. You can think this as a dynamic import. Just refer to the path. For us, it's our login component, which we have exposed as a micro frontend. And the view container reference will help us to embed that component, or to create that component in our specified location. So what we have done is we are given this reference in our HTML as an ng template, and that just render. So this question was asked by one of you guys. I will link the comment in the screen. So thanks for asking the question. So if you like the video, please hit a like, and please do subscribe to the channel so that it will motivate me to make more videos. We're going to meet in the next video. Till that, stay happy. Bye-bye.